First of all, many thanks to Ozyegin University for the kind invitation and for the opportunity. Everybody told we have listened to magnificent PowerPoints and magnificent presentations from the speakers. So digital transformation is a very popular topic nowadays. It was very popular 10 years ago, but nowadays everybody is talking about digital transformation. I would like to start a little bit historic data. Most of you should remember 10 years ago, all the people were talking about software is eating the world. Is there anybody who remembers this statement in the hall? This statement was telling us how big is the impact of software on the social and business life. And 5 years later, everybody has started to talk about the mobile technology, and this statement has converted to mobile is eating the world. And nowadays everybody is talking about another statement. You will disrupt or you will be disrupted. There is a great opportunity to disrupt, but this statement is also threatening us. If you cannot change yourself, you might be about to disappear from your sector and your business. So under these circumstances, as Pegasus Airlines, we have changed our mission statement as the IT department, I mean, and the vision statement. As you can see, we are targeting to be one of the top three airlines in the world in terms of technology. This is our aim. There is no time limitation, so we believe that we will achieve this goal. The other one is our vision. We will take a competitive advantage with the technology for the growth, profitability, and the customer experience with technology, with the help of technology. These two statements summarizes our strategy among Pegasus Airlines. Most of you have seen or remember that also Pegasus Airlines has changed this motto as the digital airline of Turkey also. So today, I'm gonna give some examples of innovative projects which we handle at the moment in Pegasus. My agenda is, I will give information about the technology benchmark. Afterwards, we have defined five pillars. In these five pillars, what kind of initiatives do we take at the moment in Pegasus? We regularly benchmark Pegasus Airlines with the biggest players of low-cost airline industry. One of them is the Wizz Air, the other one is the Ryanair. As you know, Ryanair is the maybe the biggest player in the low-cost industry in the European region. EasyJet is also one of the followers. And AirAsia and the Pegasus Airlines. Also, we benchmark ourselves with JetBlue and one of the pioneer players of technology, high technology-oriented low-cost airlines also. These five pillars are for mobile app, for CRM and campaign management, for check-in and backdrop processes, cabin and cockpit technology, and for business intelligence and analytics dimensions. We regularly benchmark Pegasus Airlines as much as we can, of course. We try to gather information from the web and et cetera. So we try to benchmark Pegasus Airlines with the top players. So the first example is about IoT. Some of the guys from the hall asked about whether there is a project about an IoT or not. We define an airline as an optimization and a planning company. We don't produce the airplanes. Our main goal as Pegasus Airlines is selling low-cost tickets to the customers, to the passengers. Selling low-cost tickets then is not a pricing strategy. It's a cost management strategy. So you have to make an efficient and effective optimization and planning process. You have to have an efficient planning process. For that purpose, we have implemented IoT devices for all the apron vehicles and equipments. So all these equipments are equipped with IoT devices. All these devices communicate each other on the apron side. Ground, if your if your airplane is flying, it generates cash. If your airplane is on the ground, it burns cash. This is a common saying in the airline industry. For that purpose, our main goal is shortening the ground time of the airplane. For shortening the ground time of the airplane, all these equipments should communicate each other effectively. And on the other side, you have to use artificial intelligence and other technologies to optimize your operations to shorten your ground time period. And also, on the other side, there are some benefits for the passenger also. We don't want our passengers wait in the plane after the after landing. Just the ladder vehicle should be just in time next to the airplane, not to make them waiting in the airplane. So this is only possible with communicating all the equipment on the apron side. This is our IoT project. We have implemented and equipped all IoT devices on the apron. And now this year, we are implementing an artificial intelligence project to optimize our processes, to optimize our planning on apron side. As most of you know, Ataturk Airport is closed, and now Istanbul, we have two big airports. One is the Istanbul Airport, the other one is the Sabiha Gökçen Airport. And the passengers are more likely to visit Sabiha Gökçen Airport nowadays. So we need more capacity. But physically, we don't have that capability at the moment. We cannot enlarge our base at the moment. But with the same physical conditions, we are aiming to install self-service projects at Sabiha Gökçen Airport. By that way, we are aiming to increase our check-in capacity or passenger handling capacity. On the other way also, we regularly make calculations for the customer satisfaction. We have calculated that. I was previously working for Garanti Bank and for also working for Turkcell. We have discovered that if a customer is getting self-service services, then they are much more satisfied and they are much more happy. For that purpose, we are working on a unique customized special device. This is a very talented device. As you can see, there is a scale on that kiosk device. There is a multi-purpose reader. For what purpose we have implemented the multi-purpose reader? How many of you have the new Turkish identity cards in the hall? 50% I mean. How many don't have? Okay, almost 50% of. As you can see, this card have many different capabilities. It has a chipset on it. There is an MRZ here. There is a barcode here. All your identity information is stored in this card. So you will be able to use your new Turkish identity cards in this device. Just touch and pass. If you show the multipurpose reader your identity card, it automatically generates your flights. Then afterwards, you can easily make your check-in or you can easily print your bag tag. And you just scale it. If you have excess baggage, you can easily also pay your, with the PayPass technology, touch and pay technology, you can easily pay your excess baggage also. And just then load it to the conveyor belt and it goes to the destination you will go. So this year, in 2 months period, we are aiming to implement 30 self-service devices at Sabiha Gökçen Airport. Also, next year, we are aiming to implement 30 more self-service devices at Sabiha Gökçen Airport. With the 60 self-service devices at Sabiha Gökçen Airport, we will be one of the, we will have one of the largest self-service stations in the European region, I think, which belongs to an airline, I mean. So, 8 months ago, we have implemented, we have handled a pilot project for express baggage. It has a special name, the self-service baggage has a special name in Pegasus. It's express baggage. Till now, more than 200,000 passengers has used these devices. So this utilization has encouraged us to implement much more devices. One of the grandfather, as I remember right, he was 88 years old, has tried and used this device. So before implementing these self-service devices, we were thinking that Turkish people is not familiar with this kind of devices. But after implementing five pilot projects, we have discovered that if the device is convenient and easy to use, everybody choose. Nobody wants to wait in the queue. Everybody wants to have self-service. I have given information about the new identity card, of course, saving time, not just for the kiosk devices, not just for the kiosk equipments. We are planning to use this new identity card at counters, at boarding. The boarding is almost ready. In this May, till the end of this May, it will be technologically ready. The passengers will be able to board themselves without using a boarding pass. They will just show their identity card and they will board. So when they go to the counter, they will just show their identity card and they will make their check-in. When they go to the kiosk devices, they will just show their identity card and they will take their bag tag or boarding pass. Of course, we are aware of that. The future of this technology is biometric. But the enrollment project is not that much easy. This kind of projects are not just related about the technology. It's also about the sociology of the country. So enrollment of the biographic data is not enlarging the enrollment of the biometric data is not that much easy. So till that period, in the 5 years period, we are aiming to utilize the identity card data. Afterwards, most probably, we will convert this technology to the biometric data. One of the friends has asked Cem about biometric data and the Hitit systems. How do you integrate these two technologies? At the moment, if you have installed Pegasus mobile application, at the moment we have face recognition capability on our mobile application. You can easily, from your face, you can log into the application and also you can list all your flights and you can make easily check-in. You have contacts, you can easily add your contacts to your flights, etc. So these biometric solutions are a kind of plug-and-play system, so you can integrate this kind of technologies to any PSS systems or any other technologic systems. So at the beginning of my presentation, I have told you about the benchmark studies. One of the pillar is the mobile application also. We compare a mobile application, as you can see, easy login, convenient payment, easy tasks, and accessibility. From easy tasks, as Elton also has mentioned, that passport scan is very significant. Also, we have a capability in our mobile app. You can easily scan your passport. You can easily scan your visa and you can make check-in very easily. And also there are convenient payment is very significant. At the moment, we are working with MasterPass and also one Turkish supplier for your storage of your credit card data. You don't have to give your card data next. You store just your credit card data. It's stored in the application. For the following months, we will store also your credit card data, which you scan. So you will not be obliged to repeatedly input your passport data or credit card data into the application. These are all about passenger convenience, convenient payment, convenient check-in. If you can make life, digital life, convenient, then people like self-service. So at the moment, fingerprint and face recognition is our capability. Ryanair is the pioneer airline in this field for the mobile application. So in this presentation, in this slide, I have mentioned, I have compared Ryanair and Pegasus Airlines. So as you can see, in the following months, there is a very significant also line here, reuse of the data. Reuse of the data means You just capture your passport data from the passenger. You just capture your visa data. You just capture the credit card information. And you can reuse that data. If you can reuse that data, you don't have to ask again and again to the customer. At the moment, we have more than 7 million passenger passport data in our systems. They are valid, not expired passport data. More than 4 million visa data. So I don't have to ask this data to the passengers again and again. So for the following months, we will implement this project. These are the info gathered from the counters, gathered from the check-in kiosks, gathered from the mobile apps. We have this data. If we can utilize this data, we will provide our passengers much more convenient self-service travel experience. So handicapped passengers are very significant for also. Voiceover and Siri check-in is coming for the in the following months. So people will be able to control their mobile apps with their voices. At the end of the year, our biggest competitor is Ryanair at the moment. Also, the competition is working on the technology, by the way. So we are following it very closely. But at the end of the year, we want to have one of the best mobile apps in the European region. This is our goal. So we are checking it with the capabilities, which you can see at the left side also. So mobility is not beneficial just for your customers. You have to empower your employees with mobile technologies and technologic projects. So the left one side, the PIN is our Pegasus Internet. It's shortened versions of Pegasus Internet. It's a mobile platform internet. You can manage all your company's processes, approvals, and you can gather information, official information, centrally distributed to the company. All this information management is managed over PIN. This is our employee mobile app. The other one is Smart Cabin. Smart Cabin is specifically is a product, mobile product, specifically targeted for the cabin crew. They are managing, they are empowered with all crew info, e-forms, announcements, schedule plans, passenger information is ready for the utilization of our cabin crew. And with the help of this application, they can differentiate their services on the cabin side. So big data is analytics. I think this topic is much more popular 5 or 10 years ago. In banking industry, in telecommunications industry, these steps were passed maybe 5 years ago. But in the airline industry, most of the customer targeted projects are focused on the frequent flyer programs. So analyzing all customer data, segmenting all customer data, making customized offers to their passengers is a new concept for us. Last year we have unified all our customer data. Till now, from the beginning, more than 35 million unique passengers has flown with Pegasus Airlines. If you check 2 years period, it's more than 18 million. So when you have your unique data, you can utilize this data in many fields. I have mentioned, for example, you want to make reuse of the data, reuse of the passport data. If you have the unique data, you can easily do that job. If you have unique credit card data, you can easily utilize that credit card data for repurchasing another ticket. If you have that data, and if you can segment that data, you can make personal offers to your passengers. And according to one of the McKinsey study, it's possible to increase your revenue 10% with personalized customer data, with special offers to your passengers. Increase your ancillary revenue, increase your ticket revenue, etc. At the moment, also, these capabilities seem some of the audience may be a little bit late, but at the beginning of this year, we have started to welcome our customers with their names and with their contact history. Contact history means if they have any complaint, our agents can see that. Our agents can see the previous flights of the passengers. They can welcome the passenger with their names and etc. So they can easily handle their tasks. Previously, before unification of the data, we were not able to handle these capabilities. And also, we have handled the travel assistant project. At the moment, at Sabiha Gökçen Airport, we are giving the conveyor belt information for the baggage of the passengers. From which conveyor belt you can pick up your luggage, we give this information to our passengers at the moment. Also, if their gate change, we give the gate change information instantly, real time. And also, there is a stroller guidance. And also, this project is enlarged with the TAV airports. Bodrum is included at the moment. Izmir is included at the moment. Ankara is included also. We are spreading it all over Turkey also. We are aiming to spread it to the European cities. Travel experience is not just getting on the airplane, getting out of it. So it starts maybe when you are purchasing the ticket, and it continues with the check-in experience at the airport. It continues when you're reclaiming your baggage. So it's an end-to-end process. If you can effectively communicate with your customer about their flight and about their goods, then they are much more happy. At the beginning of the project, we didn't expect that this customer assistant project will help us that much. But according to our calculations, more than 20 points more net promoter score has increased on the customers which we can touch with this customer assistant project. So these are the numbers which we have gained with the customer unification and data analytics studies. More than 60 million Turkish liras increase with the customer assistant project because NPS scores of the passengers has increased. So repurchase probability of the passengers has increased. According to that calculation, more than 60 million Turkish liras revenue increase has gained with the help of this project. Also, 1.5 million Turkish liras is gained with the first call resolution. If you know your customer, if you know who is calling you, you can easily handle the problem. You can better solve the problem. On the other side, also average call handling time has decreased. It's an operational efficiency side. Also, almost half a million Turkish liras gain has counted from this project. So, another example is artificial intelligence projects. Here, as you can see, there are two projects. I love artificial intelligence projects very much because there is always a dilemma: giving a better service and spending less money. It's generally not possible. If you spend more money for the customer, they are more happy. But with the help of artificial intelligence projects, you can spend less money and your customers can be much more happy. So the first one is catering load optimization. Each day we load many catering items to the airplanes and some of the items are bought by the passengers and some of them are lost. So, but we have all the historic data. So according to the schedule, sales history of the destination, demographics of the people on the airplane, and also bundle and pre-orders before the flight, and also the crew performance. Ali is selling more than Mehmet, for example. We know that data from the historic perspective. So we combine all this data and we make a prediction. And all the staff can see this prediction. We make all the loading according to this prediction. Afterwards, we get the sales records. We check our predictions. If there is an optimization area with the deep learning algorithm, we optimize our predictions. By this way, this was strange because our main purpose was at the beginning of the project was decreasing, making a saving from the less food loading. But the end point, we have increased our revenue 5 million Turkish liras because, for example, you just load 2 cheese sandwich to the airplane. Afterwards, the system recommends you 3 cheese sandwich. On the airplane, if the third customer asks you about the cheese sandwich, you don't say them, there is no cheese sandwich. You can sell it. There is a sales opportunity over there. So we were not expecting that point. But at the end of the project, we have also increased our sales with the help of this project. Also, we have saved 1 million Turkish liras. The other one is the Optimus. As you can understand from its name, Optimus is about optimizing our counters at Sabiha Gökçen Airport. The first step of the project has completed. We have worked Istanbul Technical University for this project. As you can see, and also I have mentioned, the customers most complain about the waiting times at the airport. This is the time which passengers are most unhappy. So optimizing this part is also gains value, money to us. It's an efficiency project on one side. On the other side, we have aimed to optimize and decrease the waiting times in the queue, in the counters. Like the previous project, we know what kind of passengers are on the airplane, what kind of demographics will come to the counters, how many of them has previously self-checked in, how many of them are probably come to and give a luggage. According to this information, we make our counter plannings previously. So at the end of the project, we have decreased the waiting times. 11 seconds can seem maybe low to you, but it's related with 7 or 8 million passengers. So as an average number, it has a huge impact, as you can see. And also, 7% low staff utilization has gathered after the implementation of this project. So this is another example of utilization of artificial intelligence. In the second phase of the project, we are collaborating with İsmihan, with Sabiha Gökçen Airport. They are positioning cameras at the moment, digital capturing cameras. They will feed our system with the camera information, and also we will challenge our system and optimize our system with the camera information. Then the predictions will be much more better. Afterwards, the gains will increase. So I have started the presentation with these statements. I will close my presentation with these statements. I have a small video which summarizes all these presentations. So I will finish with a small video.
Are you ready for a digital travel experience like never before? Pegasus is ready. Because we started the digital transformation process with the claim of being the digital airline of Turkey, we are creating unique solutions and innovations to enrich the travel experiences of our passengers. This is Ayşe Baluchar, a Pegasus passenger. Let's look at these innovations together by following Ayşe's travel experience. Because she logged into the mobile app using her Pegasus Bulbul membership, we recognized Ayşe right away. She can even log into the app using Face ID, Touch ID, or social media accounts without having to enter her information again. This means she can quickly purchase her ticket and any additional services and access all her flight information from her account whenever she wants. When Ayşe logs into the app with her Bulbul membership, she'll see a personalized promotion based on her purchasing and flying habits. With the Travel Assistant feature on our mobile app, we can support Ayşe through every stage of her flight. Ayşe can complete check-in without even touching a key on her phone's keypad. It automatically recognizes flights open for check-in. She can access the PNR easily while her passenger information is automatically recognized. And any additional services purchased are paid automatically with the stored credit card. Through messages sent on the day of travel, Ayşe can find out the weather forecast for her destination and the condition of the traffic in Istanbul. She completes online check-in in one step, and when she arrives at the airport, she receives instant notifications of possible gate changes, as well as boarding reminders. Since Ayşe doesn't want to wait in line at the airport, she drops off her bags herself quickly using our express baggage service. By scanning her online boarding pass, she can complete tasks such as labeling her luggage and paying for excess baggage. In fact, she can even use the new chipped ID card instead of a boarding pass to board her flight. Let's assume that Ayşe joined the queue to hand over her baggage. A again, no problem, thanks to our optimization of counter-operations algorithm supported by artificial intelligence, we can efficiently manage waiting times and queue lengths to take necessary actions, like opening new counters or directing passengers to different counters. Aisha can pre-order the meal she wants and anything else she needs before her flight. Everything is served to her by cabin crew during the flight. Our cabin crew can access all passenger information on tablets and can complete any processes or preparations, specifically for infants or disabled passengers in advance. Whether the flight is long or short, Aisha will never get bored, because with our onboard fly and watch entertainment system, there is a world of entertainment at her fingertips, from TV series to movies, games, and newspapers. With our digital operations optimization project, all pre- and post-flight operations are completed as efficiently and quickly as possible. Thanks to IoT technology, Aisha can locate the stairs for disembarking the plane and catching the bus at the right place at the right time. Aisha has reached her destination with the brand new Pegasus experience. That's how flying with us is now. Digital at every stage. We are Pegasus, the digital airline of Turkey.
Thank you. If you have any questions, I'll be glad to answer. Maybe the microphone.
I will not ask question. I will just thank you. I'm working for airline business almost 35 years. I worked in Turkish Airlines. I never been able to make any reservation or buying a ticket from internet because I was from the paper ticket time. But first time in my life, I've been able to buy my ticket by myself, make my check-in, and do all the things which you have presented in your video. So I'm thanking to you.
Thank you very much.
First of all, you made something useful for passenger, even in my age, which is a little bit far away to technology. It is not complicated, but very helpful for a passenger for every stage of the travel. So I'm thanking
Thank
to you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Any more questions?
Hi, my name is Anthony. I used Pegasus recently, but I was not quite. How does personal check-in that attracts charges increase revenue? Isn't that discouraging for personal check-in?
I couldn't get the point. Could you please repeat the question? Sorry for that.
Personal check-in online. Online check-in, I mean.
Online check-in, huh?
Yeah. When I checked, it attracts charges for check-in. So how does that make the online check-in attractive, make it user-friendly?
We don't charge for online check-in.
I noticed that.
But seat selection is an ancillary product. Yes, you're right. If you wanna wish to choose your seat for extra leg place for the frontier seats, then it's for charge. But otherwise, you can make online check-in. It's free, of course. It's free. Buying online tickets is the ticket price. No extra charge. I'm not sure we could answer your question, but hope so.
I was the one who did not ask the question properly. I was talking about choosing a seat.
Yeah, but yeah. Okay. I got your point, but maybe I should talk maybe 1 minute about low-cost concept. Pegasus Airlines is a low-cost airline. What does low-cost mean? Low-cost means you don't pay for the products which is bought by your friend. For example, some passengers like to drink on the airplane, some passengers like to eat on the airplane, some passengers like to sit in the frontier seats in the airplane, but some passengers don't care about this. So our aim is giving the lower price to the passengers who do not utilize this kind of extra services. So to provide these lower prices, we have to extra charge the other passengers who wants to utilize these extra services. This is the low-cost concept, and this is a very successful concept. This is not invented by Pegasus Airlines. There are many big players at European region and also in the United States and etc. All over the world, I mean. So Pegasus Airlines is a just example of this low-cost airline concept in Turkey. So this is the business model. It's not something wrong, I think, in my opinion. This is an opportunity for people to make them able to buy lower-priced tickets. This is the business case. This is a business model. Any other questions?
Hi. You were talking about artificial intelligence. And in Optimus part, there were three features. One of them was university collaboration. What kind of collaboration do you have?
We worked with Istanbul Technical University. We have analyzed the project, but for the development part and also for the artificial intelligence part, the lecturers from the universities come and diagnose the problem. And for the development side of the project, we work together. We have collaborated for the development side of the project.
Thank you.
For technical part, for the technical part, yeah. The analysis part of the project is handled by the Pegasus Airlines. The business case and the problem is defined by the Pegasus Airlines, and is solved technically by the guys who came from Istanbul Technical University.
Hello. Firstly, thank you for your presentation. I just wonder something. Are there any threats in terms of cybersecurity, for instance, big data or BI?
Several months ago, we had a robot attack. The robots have tried to reserve all available seats. There is an algorithm, maybe you are familiar with that. There is an algorithm which is called, in the airline industry, it's a common algorithm. There is a concept of incomplete PNR. When you choose your destination and the dates, you just send a query to the system, and the system brings you the prices. At that point, to keep the prices for you, we create an incomplete PNR. After almost 15 minutes, we release that PNR if the buying activity do not accomplish itself. We release the PNR. The robots came, but millions of requests come to the system. They tried to book all available seats. At that point, if a regular passenger tries to book a seat, they see no available seat in the system. So it was a huge problem, but with the help of artificial intelligence technologies also, this is an artificial intelligence technology. The threat is created by artificial intelligence, but the solution comes from artificial intelligence. These robots come with a pattern. So the artificial intelligence algorithms can detect that pattern. At that night, we have implemented a solution with the help of Akamai technologies. We have captured the pattern which robot came to our systems. So we have blocked all the robot transactions. Afterwards, our systems is at the moment safe. But all the digital systems, all the digital companies are under the threat of this kind of robotic or other kind of information security cyber attacks. So we have to be ready. We have to be in front of them. When they go two steps away, we have to catch them. So we have to implement and invest for new technologies. for defending ourselves also. We have to utilize this kind of artificial intelligence technologies. There is no way. But it was a strange, really, it was a strange event. Any other questions?
First of all, thank you for the speech. Related to cybersecurity, I want to ask if I'm as a passenger not comfortable in UK airline keeping my data, can I request them to delete it permanently after my flight?
Of course, there is a possibility for deleting all your data. You have to apply for that with the call center or emails and etc. If you wish us to delete all your data, we delete them.
No, just like my credit card information or Visa card. If I want them to be deleted.
If you wish to store it, you store it. Otherwise, we don't store your credit card data.
Thank you.
If you wish to store, you check it. I want to store my MasterPass data, MasterCard data. Then we store it. For the next time you come to our system, you can easily. It's a convenience product. It's a convenience service. If you wish to utilize that service, you utilize. Otherwise, we don't make you enforced to store your credit card data in Pegasus systems.
Thank you so much.
No problem. Thank you.